Analysis from Oxford has come today to the magnificent new Blavatnik School of Government, designed by Herzog and de Meuron, the very famous Swiss architects. What we're celebrating today is Oxford AIM Day 2018. AIM Day was devised by Uppsala University in Sweden as a unique way of getting industry and academics together to exchange ideas.
Today we are hosting an academic industry meeting day on the theme of biomedical imaging. Industry interaction and collaboration is crucial for healthcare innovation. Neither the academics nor the industry can do it alone. These partnerships are recognised from both sides to be very important, and we're here to try to help develop those.
But I think it is absolutely essential to work with industry. We as academics have a certain strength. We work on a particular problem, be it a technical challenge or a new application. Industry understands best how to really then go all the way and translate this into direct patient benefit that can be rolled out and benefit hopefully millions of patients in this country and other countries. And so they're very complementary sets of expertise that we can bring together with a day like this. And so far it's been very enjoyable and productive.
I think there's a huge amount of potential in the science and the research that's done at the University of Oxford that can actually help industry. But what we need from industry is to know what problems we should be working on. And it's only together that we can really have a positive impact on clinical outcomes.
Following our short seminar session, we moved into a series of parallel workshops. We have 6 rooms booked in the Blavatnik School of Government, with meetings running over 5 sessions during the day. Again, broken up with networking sessions to allow people to continue the discussion and continue developing their new relationships.
So the benefits of industry engaging with academia are pretty obvious, really. I mean, it's all very well doing your research in the laboratory or at the hospital or what have you, but if you can't make a direct impact on patient outcomes or, you know, making people feel better with the research you're doing, you know, what's the point? And industry obviously have the best way to actually make sure that that research actually gets into the hospital, gets into the clinic and have an impact on everybody's lives. The kind of discussions we're having today will hopefully build those bridges, those links between that, and so we can have that sort of penny drop moment of, oh yeah, we just do this, we can take this from here, put it into here and hopefully get it into the hospital.
So this interaction between industry and academia is very useful because we see more how we work with data and big data, how we can tackle the challenge of big data.
All the time we are facing new problems to solve and we want to keep in touch with the latest technology, so that comes from academy. And we are using machine learning a lot to solve this problem, so that's why we like to link ourselves with the academia, because we might find a useful human resource or some good ideas to solve some of our problems in imaging.
Industry can't do all the kind of more novel research, and so it needs to link with academia, because academic groups usually are doing kind of the more novel, kind of risky perhaps types of research, and for us to get a kind of a look in on that, I think it's quite useful to kind of have links with it.
Many times we work independently, and in the end I think we should all be looking for the same aims, right? So we are all interested in advancing the field, and we are, as academics, we are interested in seeing our ideas applied as much as possible. And I think for that, this connection between academia and industry is really fundamental.
It's a satisfying way of providing kind of new research questions that then lead to application. Academics can easily sit at one end of the spectrum and industry can sit at the other, and it feels like quite a long way to go from one stage to the other. Actually, if industry is prepared to look and see about the sort of academic problems that are being solved, and the academics are listening to, okay, where does this end up? We find it a bit easier to bridge that gap somewhere ultimately by having that conversation and moving in and out all of the time.